Have you ever scrolled through someone's GitHub profile and noticed all those cool badges? And you wonder, how did they get those? In this video, I'll teach you how to easily unlock a lot of those GitHub badges in the next few minutes. Now, before we begin, here's a short disclaimer. This content is intended solely for educational purposes and to show how easy it is to fake your profile on the internet. I do not endorse using it to gain an unfair advantage over others. For the first badge, you can use an existing non-empty public repository or create a new one like I'm doing here. I recommend creating a new one for these badges because they're going to trigger the upcoming conditions in the same repository. Now you want to go to the issue section of the repository and open up a new issue. Give it any name and click on create. Once you create this issue, you want to go ahead and close it within 5 minutes and this will give you the QUICKDRAW achievement. Now let's quickly move on to the second one. Click on the repository you just used or created and edit any file. In my case, I'll go ahead and edit the readme file that we included while creating this repository. Go ahead and click on the commit changes button and this will give us options to either directly commit to the main branch or create a separate PR. We will select the second option and create a pull request. Wait for a few seconds or refresh if it takes longer and you'll see an option to merge this pull request. This means that our code changes are merged with the main branch from the separate branch that we created successfully. To get the second achievement, we'll have to do the same process just one more time. So head on back to the code section, make an edit, commit changes, create a separate branch and create a PR, and then merge it. And just like that, we already have the second achievement. As simple as that, and you already have two achievements in your GitHub profile. For the third and fourth achievement, you might want to pause the video and add another account to GitHub to accept your collaboration request. This may be your friend's account or just an alternate account of yours. Like me, if you don't have any friends, you can send me your collaboration request and I'll gladly accept all of them. We'll only need this account to act as a collaborator of the repository that we're using. Start by clicking on the repository we're using and go to the settings tab and under access you'll find collaborators. Click on the add people button and search for the username of the other account that we are adding as a collaborator. Now switch to the account that you sent the request to or ask your friend to accept the invitation from their inbox. Switch back to your main account and edit any file like we did before. While committing changes, make sure to select the second option that will create a separate branch to create a pull request and click on the propose changes button. In the PR creation page, you will see an option to add reviewers on the right. Click on the settings button and select the account you just added as a collaborator. If you don't see any other account here, make sure you have accepted the collaborator invitation on the other account or ask your friend to do so. Once you have added them, go ahead and click on the create pull request button and merge it. Go to your profile and hit refresh and you'll find your third badge right there. Now for the fourth one, you might want to pause the video again and go to desktop.github.com/download and download GitHub Desktop. Once you have installed it, log in with your main account, select the repository you've been using and clone it at a location on your computer that you're aware of. Now we need to make changes to this file locally. For this, you can either open it in VS Code by clicking this button or open that file with your notepad and make a change in it and save it. Once you see the changes appear here, click on the main selected branch and add a new branch. I'll call it main 3. Make sure to switch to the bring my changes to the new branch option and click on the switch branch button. After that, you'll see an option to commit your changes to your new branch on the bottom left of the window, where you'll also see an option to add a collaborator on your commit. Go ahead and select the collaborator that we added earlier and click on the push origin button in the center. This will push the separate branch we created locally to GitHub. As you can see on my browser, I see this option to compare and pull request. Click on it and confirm that your commit was successfully co-authored. If you don't see two avatars here, you will not get this badge and you're probably doing something wrong. Now as usual, let's create this PR and merge it. You can check your profile to find the fourth achievement now. These are all the easily doable achievements you can get. For the rest, we'll have to be a bit more patient and trigger these conditions rationally. To get Galaxy Brain, go to github.com/orgs/community/discussions and answer as many discussions marked as questions honestly and in a helpful manner. If some of your answers get accepted as answers at least twice, you will get the achievement. To get Starstruck, you'll need to have at least 16 stars on your repository. As you can see, I've got this badge from all the love you guys showed me on my previous video. If this video hits 1000 likes, I'll create a tool that allows you to get 16 stars in your repository by automated bots or like a like-for-like system that lets you like others' repos and get your own likes. Moving on with the video, for the last and the final achievement that you can get on your profile, you can get a public sponsor achievement by making a monthly or one-time donation to someone. You can choose to sponsor your favorite profile or organization on GitHub by finding this sponsor button on their profile. And if you don't have anyone to sponsor, you can always sponsor me at github.com/sponsor/fenrir2608. If enough of you donate, I promise to buy a yacht and name it open source. And that was it for this video. If you want to learn how to hack your contribution graph and generate random looking commits to past dates, you should check out this video. Let me know in the comments if you want to learn how to make a Discord girlfriend bot or something for my next video. If you found this video helpful, leave a like and subscribe for more videos like this.